Well, even a second Australian Open title wasn't enough to force Naomi Osaka into a wild night of celebrations. Instead, the 23-year-old is already eyeing the future and her path to the top. Braden Ingram with more.
A shoe malfunction meant Naomi Osaka was an hour late to her own championship party, which didn't quite go to script. But this was about as wild as it got.
The biggest thing I wanted to do was go to sleep, so I took a 2-hour nap after I won, and now I'm here.
The understated 23-year-old instead leaving all her celebrations on court.
Osaka has done it again!
With a straight sets win over American Jennifer Brady, Osaka secured her fourth Grand Slam crown, and in turn opened the debate as to whether we're witnessing a changing of the guard.
I feel like it's an honour that I'm in that conversation, but I also feel like for me, my biggest goal is to be consistent throughout the year, not just like randomly popping up and winning a Grand Slam.
Having established herself as a leading force in women's tennis, Osaka now has her eye on the two majors not in her trophy cabinet, the French Open and Wimbledon. Despite rising to number two in the world, Osaka is yet to dethrone the top-ranked Ash Barty. But this trip down under is one she'll never forget.
The atmosphere yesterday was definitely something that will be etched into my memory.
Braden Ingram, 9 News.
All right, let's head live now to Melbourne Park ahead of the men's final, and Clint Stanaway is there. Clint, we are set for a huge finale.
And rightly so, Alicia. Good evening to you. Just getting to this point has been a huge logistical challenge. As we know, the man entrusted with getting us to the finish line is Craig Tiley. Craig, what's the overriding emotion right now?
Well, I think it's not really a relief because we're thinking about 2022, but I mean, just very proud. I think that's what it is. Just proud of the team, what they've delivered. And many people thought this wasn't going to happen and couldn't happen, and we really made it happen.
You got the chance to be reunited with your family today. You got to sit with them in the crowd. Did they recognise you?
Well, it's the first time in daylight I think I've seen them in 6 weeks. They came to watch doubles. There's one person playing doubles that they know well, so they came to watch for a little bit, and it was just nice to spend 5 minutes with them.
A big night tonight, men's final night. Who's your tip?
Well, you got the person who owns this court, Djokovic, playing the hottest player on the tour right now, so it's a toss-up, so I'll leave it up to you to decide who's going to win it.
I think Medvedev, maybe.
You think Medvedev? I think that's probably a good tip.
All right, thanks, Craig. Congratulations. And, Alicia, we'll see you soon with sport.
We look forward to it. It's going to be a big night. Clint Stanaway there. We'll come back to him soon.